Hello, art faculty at SCAD. This is the series of works for my 45-hour review. I'm going to begin with the earliest works that I worked on in my studio classes at SCAD, and these are illustrating my experience as a Mexican-American growing up on the border. They are filled with iconography that I was exposed to at a young age, balancing both cultures. So that's why you see my self-portrait as this comic character with glasses, the central panel being more the one in which how I perceive my notion of being American, with the stars over my eyes being almost dazzled by what I was seeing in popular culture. And so these were early works that were exploring who I was, my identity, and what were the things that were influencing my work. In this series, I'm illustrating the theme of family memories. Every Sunday I would meet with my grandmother and we would sit and talk for hours, and I would always ask to look at an old family album. And in the album, I was drawn to these beautiful photographs, black and white, and I always wondered how they would look like if there was color added. They would tell me about stories of growing up in Mexico, and I was raised in the United States, so I couldn't relate too much to that. So in these series, I'm trying to really explore the stories of my family and where they came from, but also with a splash of color, which is what I'm doing here. In the past review, the discussion came about appropriation and really just looking to those personal stories, the personal narrative. So some of these have been changed after that 15-hour review, and I'm very happy and pleased with the taking away of some of the dots in the composition in some of these pieces. In the birthday one, I left some of those circles just to continue with the shapes of the balloons and the painting. But overall, I've edited some of these paintings, added some more color, and altered some of the themes that I had originally done in my 15-hour review. This painting here, when they're dancing, and the painting of my grandfather are all part of that series of family memories. Again, really took the time to look at the composition and really alter it. Again, given all my feedback that I received in the 15-hour review, trying to give a different interpretation, different feeling with the different change of color. And the one with my grandfather, there was two figures, and I took away one figure and I added the helicopter, the story that was behind that photograph was very important. So I decided to change that. This arrangement of the wooden little panels that I created in my other studio class, I really wanted to give that form of a rosary in the circular form. And again, inspired by my mom, her life, and all the things that represent who she was. This is a new piece that was mixed media for photography and painting. Pasting the photograph onto the canvas and then painting on the image. I didn't want to distort too much of the original photograph, so that's why I decided to just do a very thin layer of paint, almost as a wash on the figure. This painting is part of the newest series that depicts an offering, a table with the portraits of my mom and my dad, with the inscription, Viva la Vida, or Long Live Life, united by the rosary, elements of my culture, food, and still using these bright colors that I'm attracted to and working with, and really telling that story. The retablo that I created for this course is looking at the issues of immigration, which is something that I've explored in my artist statement, things that interest me, and trying to create this entire different world based in my own imagination of what the symbolism of the masks represent, and just getting lost in the imagery. There was many challenges with this one, but I had to revisit it and rework some areas to really enhance that theme that I wanted to explore. So there's many areas here that I have revamped, and you will see the before image and a current one to see the difference. This is a portrait of my mom and dad, their wedding, and this was part of a series of images to honor the women in our lives. It was a show that I was asked to be part of, so I incorporated the wallpaper, the solid background in blue. And again, I pasted the photograph and painted on the photograph. I didn't want to paint so much over their faces that it would take away from the beauty of the photograph. But I'm very pleased with how this one came out. It's personal, it's narrative. It's something that really is based on, again, old photographs. From this painting on, these were the pieces that I submitted for the 15-hour review. And these were a bit of a challenge because I had to be personal. I had to tap into that narrative. And at the current time, my mom was sick with cancer, and it was a very rough time. And in a way, this is my response to what I was experiencing. So I took inspiration from one of her letters, and I took pieces from the letter and spread them out through all the different canvases. So this one represents more with all the love of the world, her portrait, cactus, very representative of Mexican landscape, the rosary. Again, this painting, along with the rest of them, have been updated, they've been changed with the text. Originally they didn't have the text, but I did want to push that personal narrative a little bit further. So I incorporated the text here with the addition of the Milagro charm, which is very popular as a devotion to the Hispanic culture. So all of these are phrases that were in the letter, their blessing. So may God bless you, help you, take care of you, protect you, and keep illuminating your path. Your family that is always there, we love you and we miss you. We wait to see each other very soon. We greet you and we bless you. These hands are not my mother's hands. In the last 15-hour review, I was asked if they were, and they're not. I guess at the moment I wasn't ready to really use her own hands because of what I was going through, so I defaulted to these hands. But I still wanted to put the personal part of the letter there. And it's something that I want to revisit. One day I'll paint her hands. But for this presentation, I wanted to just keep with what I had her recreate. This painting has just two very simple words. Wisdom and infinite. Always this tone that my mom had in her letters of always being wise, the way you treat people and your disposition and anything that you're doing, you always have to be wise. And the possibilities are just infinite. And this is the final painting for this video presentation. It illustrates our representative wisdom, the Milagro charms, which all have their own significant purpose. And at the bottom it reads, abundant blessings and lots of success with good fruits. So in looking at all of these works, paintings, they all, for me, have a very personal thread connected to them. And that's my family, my culture, and all the traditions that make me who I am. As an artist, as an educator, as a creative individual. So.